Welcome to another video of cloud computing in AWS. And today we are going to look at an extra lab, which is an extra activity for us. Now in this lab, we are going to create a VPC. We build and launch a web server, and then we launch an RDS. So let us go now and create a VPC. The first thing I will do is to create an Elastic IP. And this Elastic IP will be assigned to the NAT gateway. Then I will go now to the VPC dashboard, and from the VPC dashboard, I'm going to basically launch a VPC using the VPC wizard. As you can see now, I will click on launch VPC, then I will select VPC with public and a private subnet. I will call this VPC lab VPC. Now the first subnet is going to be based on the lab architecture, is going to be in the first availability zone. So I'm going to put it in the first availability zone. And the private subnet is going to be as well in the first availability zone. I'll locate the Elastic IP and then click on a create. Now this will take a while. So let us go back to inspect the architecture. The next thing is going to be to launch a web server. But before we launch a web server, we need to create a security group for the web server to open port 80. Then we are going to create another security group for the RDS to enable port the MySQL port. And then we will test the connection between the web server and the RDS. So the VPC is ready. Let us go now to the subnets. Now we can test from the VPC column name. We can test the subnets we just created. And now I want to go and create another subnet, and this will be the public subnet 2. And as you can see in the diagram, the public subnet 2 is going to be in the second availability zone. I will put the IP address based on the architecture. /24 and then click on create subnet, then go back, create another subnet, and this will be in the lab VPC, and I will call it a private subnet 2. We need to make sure that we follow the lab sheet, and this is going to be the same IP as you can see here in my lab sheet. It's 10.0.3.0/24, and then click on create subnet. You can go back now and sort by the VPC name to see that you have 4 subnets, and you can now start working on the next task. So now let us go to the route table, and you can see we have 2 route tables, one with main equal yes and one with main equal no. Now the one with main equal yes, this is the main route table. It has 2 destinations, one to the local and one to the NAT gateway. The other one in the lab VPC with main equal no, it has 2 destinations, and this is going to the internet gateway. So based on that, we could go back and we edit the name with the route table main equal yes, and we call it private route table. Click save. Now go to the subnet association, edit subnet association, and select the private subnet 1 and the private subnet 2. Then go back to the route table with main equal no, edit the name and call it public route table. Click save. Go to the subnet association, edit, and add now public subnet 2, because public subnet 1 was already associated with this route table by the VPC wizard. You could verify your steps by selecting the route table and just check the 2 subnets which are associated with each route table. Now, if you go to the lab sheet, you can see there is basically a web server, and this web server needs a security group. So let us go and create a web security group. This is to allow HTTP traffic to the web server. And make sure to select the VPC ID, which is the lab VPC, not the default VPC. Click Add Rule, select HTTP, and from anywhere we want it to be, because we want anyone to access the HTTP. You could also add another rule for IPv6 if you want, if this is needed. Now go back to the security group, and now we need to create another security group for the RDS. Click on Create Security Group, call it RDSSG. This is to allow access to the MySQL server or to the RDS. Make sure to select the lab VPC, add rule, and now select MySQL Aurora. And this will be linked with anywhere if you want, or you can just allow the traffic to come from the web security group to the RDS, which can add an extra layer of security to our RDS. Let's go now and launch an EC2. This will be the web server, and we will use the script provided in the lab sheet and in the description down below. So select the T2 micro. Now this is will be in the lab VPC. Select it to be in the public subnet based on the lab architecture. Click on enable auto assign public IP, because we need to have a public IP for the web server. Select the script and then click on next. Now in the tags, we name this as a web server. In the security group, we select an existing security group, and this is will be the web security group. Click continue. We don't need an SSH port to be open. And select the Vocarium key, or create a new PIM file if needed based on your lab setting, or if you are doing this from a root user account with no access to the AWS Academy lab. Now let us go to the RDS and create a new RDS. Before we create the RDS, we want to create a subnet group, and that subnet group will be used for placing the RDS in the private subnet. So click on Create Subnet Group. We call it DB Subnet Group. Now in the description, we want to describe it as a DB Subnet Group again, and then select Lab VPC. And this will be in the first and the second availability zone. And the reason why we know, because we just create two subnets in those two zones. And those are private subnet 1 and private subnet 2. You can select the one with 10.0.1 and 10.0.3. And you can also verify if you are not sure which subnet you need to select. You could go back and verify from the VPC ID, from the subnet ID, and the IP address associated with the subnet. You can verify which subnet you will use for launching your RDS. So we did select the right one, and now we can basically click on create. Now we have a subnet group. Let us go back to the dashboard, create an RDS. This is will be a MySQL dev test or a free tier. Now let us give it a database identifier. Let us call it extra lab, just to distinguish this from previous labs we did. And now for the username, we keep it admin, and we put a password like lab-password. Confirm the password again. Now go down and select the DB T3 micro, disable enable auto scaling, and now select the lab VPC, and you will find that the DB subnet group by default selected. For security group, now we need to select the RDS security group, and sometimes you need to check the port that it is the right port number. And now for additional configuration, just put the DB name. In our case, it's going to be lab. You can call it demo if you want. Disable automated backup, enhanced monitoring, and then create a database. So the database will be in creation, and this will take time. Let us go now to the EC2, and we need to test that the EC2 is available, running, and the website that we put there, the demo application, is running. So let us put the public IP in a new tab, and we can see now the RDS is ready. All we need to do is to provide the endpoint, the database, the username, and the password as well. So let us wait for the RDS to be ready. Sometimes it takes 5 minutes to finish the creation process. Now the database is available. So we have the endpoint, and now we paste the endpoint. The database name is lab. If you forget which database name you did, you could go back to the configuration and check the DB name. Username is admin. Again, from the configuration tab, you can find all this information. Click admin. And now put the password. In my case, it was lab-password. And click on submit. You can see now the database is successfully connected from the web application. And we can now test our ability to add a new record or delete existing record as well. So let us put some demo data like baz. And this will be just to test that I can write to the RDS as well with a demo email. And then click on submit. And this is pretty much what you need to do for this lab. Thank you for seeing this video, and see you in the next one.